Tech recently visited the National Defense Industrial Association's Future Force Capability Conference at Fort Benning, Georgia. That conference combines small arms, robotics, EOD, munitions, and other technologies to really enable the future warfighter to fight on a future battlefield and to build those types of formations that the Army and the other services are going to need. And while much of the conference was conceptual and, you know, service members and industry talking about different programs and desires and capabilities, there was a range day the last day, and that's where we got to see some of the stuff really in action. And on the range, there were a number of booths, more than a dozen, but there were three key themes that really popped out that are relevant to soldiers, sailors, airmen, and Marine, anyone shooting a weapon in the United States military. One of the key things we noticed was suppression. Basically, every weapon on the range, from machine gun and otherwise, was suppressed. We saw a 50 caliber machine gun suppressed. Maybe a little surprising, but it worked. Didn't even need hearing protection. Also, 338 Norma Mag machine gun, basically the 50 cal / 7.62 replacement for SOCOM, also suppressed. All the suppression worked effectively. It was pretty interesting to see the audio signature difference, where even hearing protection wasn't necessarily needed to fire these big machine guns that are quite loud and quite a presence on the battlefield. Marksmanship training was key. The Marine Corps adopted a moving marksmanship kind of target, a robotic target system made by a company called Marathon a few years ago. Well, it was on display at this range as well. And shooters can do a variety of scenarios. They can have kind of predictable outcomes on how the robots move, or make the robots move kind of of their own accord almost. And they have to react to those situations, firing at close targets, medium and far range targets in different kinds of settings with barricades and without. And beyond troops just shooting weapons themselves, they also have options to stabilize those weapons on other platforms, basically a carriage assembly that would hold the weapon in place, whether it's on a vehicle, a boat, or a helicopter, or stationed in place on, say, a tripod for a sentry position. In addition to that, they're also showing ways that use drones to stabilize those weapons in air, bring the weapon to bear on the target, always, of course, being controlled by a human in the loop.